Thank you, Dr. Misra. Now I request Sri Vijay Kumar from eMudra Solutions to give his perspective from the CA side as well as whatever his overall experiences that would also be helpful for the audience. Over to you, Vijay. You can share your screen also. We'll make you a host once.
Thank you, Dr. Balaji. Thanks to the team for organizing this webinar. Very glad that we are able to be part and share our perspective. So, on the screen, I am running through a small presentation. So this topic is Trusted Certificates Enabling Secure Workflow. Lab centers have, in a very detailed manner, shown the technical working of the digital signature certificates, as well as the previous speaker also covered on the legal angle of the digital signature. So I'm not going to touch upon that. So primarily, I'm going to cover on the trusted certificates which are enabling the secure workflow. And now CC has introduced different form of digital signature. So more emphasis, I will also drive on the new electronic signature and also give a small demo on how exactly eSign works so that we can go through that. So yeah. So this, we are very well aware. So trust has to be created. When we said there is a trust required, as Dr. Balaji mentioned, that CCA is the root of trust. So they form as the root certifying authority in India, and they license the CAs to operate as licensed certifying authorities. So eMudra actually comes here in between as a issuing license CA. So we manage and operate necessary infrastructure to issue digital signature certificates. As Harshprabha Madam already said, there are about 15 certifying authorities in India now. So eMudra is one of them. So all the certifying authorities manages the PKI and issue certificates. So at the consumers area, so there are two parts actually. So one is the actual owners of the digital signature certificates. So there are three types of certificates what we issue. One is individual certificate, second is organization users or organization individuals, and third is purely organization certificates. So these are the three types of certificates. And these certificates are used with the application. So it may be your workflow system or e-office system, or maybe even your tax system, GST system. So different systems. So these systems are called as relying parties who rely on the digital signature certificates. So once again, they have some validation system with them. So the validation will check with whether the certificates are issued by license CA and then only accept such digital signature certificates. So this is the overall scope of trust. So root of trust is established by root certifying authority, that is CCA. they give the legally recognized signatures. So these are the key points on my right hand side. So trusted certificates are issued by CA. It is legally valid under IT Act. Multiple forms of signing, including USB token, what the previous presenter has already shown. And also now there is cloud-based e-sign, which is increasing rapidly. Then there is these certificates are available, as I said, as individual and organization individual certificates, but also there is something called organizational document signer certificates for server based automated signing requirements. This is for signatures where the servers are doing themselves on behalf of the organization and not on behalf of any particular individual's action. Then there is also timestamping facility, what is available as per the root of trust. I will also explain that brief in next slide. Then the relaying parties or the workflow systems are neutral to all CAs and accept certificates by any CA under the root of trust. So all the 15 CAs can issue the certificates, and relaying parties or the workflow systems accept with the equal trust on those certificates. So this is a quick intro about eMudra. I'm not going to go much in detail, but yes, we have different solutions on this particular area, and we work with several government organizations, banking, financial services. So all this segment we cater to in this particular space. So eMudra is very deep in creating a trusted digital world. So our offerings are primarily on the certifying authority services, which are three different pieces, as I explained. So one is digital certificates, like the DSC, what is it called as, then the encryption certificates. There are also some other areas like SSL for web security, code sign for application signing. then SMIME for email signing. So different types of certificates are applicable under this umbrella. Then the electronic signature, this is online remote signing. There is no requirement of hardware token in this. It can integrate with any application. You can sign from desktop or mobile, so different application. I'll go much deeper to this over next few slides. Timestamping is the third offering. It's a trusted timestamping used with digital signatures usually, but if you use eSign, we have inbuilt the timestamping. So any electronic signature you request from our server, it will also timestamp and give. Timestamp is more like, it's a trusted timestamping. Instead of relying on the local computer time of the signer, timestamping will deliver the time from the trusted system, which is trusted by application and legally valid in the country. So that is on timestamping. So eMudra also enables with several solutions to do this with enterprises. So we work with e-governance and several other enterprises across the country. We have more than 600 organizations using our applications. So primarily there is EM Signer, which is a complete workflow platform what we provide. It supports DSC as well, eSign. It's available on cloud as well as on-premise. It's msigner.com. Then integrate with existing applications. So I will also cover in a slide how exactly this works. Then eMAST is an authentication platform what we provide for enterprises, digital authentication platform used by most banks and e-governance apps, applications, accept DSC-based authentication, and also supports all kind of signature validations inbuilt in this. Then also we have our MLabs as a solution division. So it has tailor-made security offerings, leveraging PK at the core. So all the solutions are having PK at the core of it. And this makes PK work easily with IoT and blockchain kind of new technologies. So these are the broad scope of services what we offer, which is aimed at creating a trusted digital world. So I'll run through two slides on EM Signer, the secure workflow platform. It is made in India, made by us for the world. So we have global customers using this across the world. So when we say of workflow, secure workflow system, what are the important things to look for? So first is the security. It should be highly secure and provide high assurance in the workflow system. Second is it should be very much efficient. It should be done in just a few clicks, even from your mobile, so that it should not be very complicated that you should require very specialized devices to do that. So workflow system should be efficient. There should be low cost implication. It should not be so costly that you cannot adopt that system easily. So it should be a low cost system. Then legally compliant. So yes, it should be legally compliant under the laws. So this workflow system, how does it work? So basically, if you see on my left hand side is the certifying authority, which provides remote signing and DSC kind of digital signing solutions. On the right hand side is the workflow system. So we call it MSigner paperless office. It can integrate with any of the existing system. It can be e-governance system or e-office system or even any corporate application. So it can integrate with multiple applications. Users of that applications are shown here below, the user ecosystem of that application. There can be individuals, there can be organizational users. So they can access from web or mobile. So they can perform that. And they get digital signature from the certifying authority or remote signing services and use it in workflow system. So this is a broad overview. I'm not going much in detail on this, how exactly workflow platform works, but yes, you can easily consume the trusted digital certificates in that. Then the other aspect what I wanted to cover is on the paperless DSC. This is also CCA Madam and Harshma Madam has already indicated in their opening remarks. Now government has introduced this paperless DSC, which is mandatory from February 2020. It is fully online, quick and secure. There is no more paper required. So this is a very big move which has helped people of the country to get digital signatures. So there are three aspects what I wanted to cover. One is this paperless DSC enables you to get DSC within 30 minutes. So in eMudra, we process thousands of digital signature certificate applications every day. and 90% of those applications are processed within 30 minutes. Significantly, I can say 80-85% are processed within 15 minutes also. So it's quick. There is very less rejection rate. So there are not too many rejections because these are all online. There are no paper or attestation level rejections what are happening now. Then if user has a USB token, it can be downloaded on approval so that within 30 minutes, it can be even downloaded. Else, if you don't have a token, it is delivered generally within a day. Then it is fully paperless. As I said, no paper required, fully secure online request and verification process backed by eSign. There is AI-enabled video verification system so that we perform the physical verification of the person through an video. It has artificial intelligence enabled, so it makes the photo match, the video match. There are a lot of fraud prevention mechanisms to detect whether it's the right person or not. And if AI match is true, it just goes through one person verification. But if AI match is false, there are two independent officers verifying that particular record. So those kind of systems are already in place as permitted by CCA. Then online, email, and mobile verifications are performed, linked with most of the government ID systems like PAN, GSTIN, and also offline Aadhaar system for seamless vetting. So when organization KYC, if you the details are authentic what you have provided. So in this paperless DSC, there are multiple modes of verification what is performed. So user can opt for any of the mode as per the applicable provision. So if individuals, there are three modes, or I can say it's basically two modes, offline Aadhaar and PAN KYC based. Offline Aadhaar in the sense the applicant will download the offline Aadhaar XML file from UIDAI website and upload it during the applying process and get the DSC. PAN KYC is like they give the PAN number, give the name as per the PAN. We cross-check the details with the income tax APIs. And then we also verify the scanned copy of the documents uploaded. That's the PAN card and address proof. And also we make the video match in both the cases and then issue the certificate. Bank KYC is a limited provision where banks can directly share their KYC information in a specified format as per the guidelines of CCA. And that will ease the onboarding and we can issue DSC even in that case. We are working with a couple of banks now where we are enabling those bank users to get their digital signatures directly. Organization individuals, if they have to apply, there are two modalities. One, if they are government applicant, there is a KYC provision where number of documents required varies. If it's a non-government, there is a different process. And also in government applicant, currently there is no video or mobile verification required. This is all through the undertaking by the authorized signatory of that government organization. Then the third KYC mode is foreign applicants, foreign individuals and foreign organizations also can get the DSC now without any physical paper. So they can apply online and get the DSC. This is also processed in the same time span. Most of them are approved within 30 minutes. So moving on, the last part of the presentation, I have few slides on this, is eSign. This is a very big move by our regulator, eSign, the way it is going. Because the CC office introduced electronic signatures in the country in 2015, but in 2018, September, there was a court order limiting the usage of Aadhaar when the eSign usage dropped substantially. But yes, government was very proactive to bring in the measures to enable eSign back with other possible models and keeping law in the center of that. So eSign version 3 was released by government and we provide that service as well. So this particular electronic signature, the electronic signature scheme, what CC has introduced, it has been used by, as in the initial presentation they covered, it is used by almost 11 crore people. So we request everyone to join this digital journey where more than 10 crore Indians are there. This is a key digital transformation program by Indian government enabling digital future for all Indians. So this is a very important thing. So I will cover a couple of slides on that. So as I said, it's a key element of paperless revolution as part of government's Digital India program. A lot of adoption is happening day by day. There are 170 plus use cases what has been already evaluated for this e-sign, and larger adoption is happening. I will also quickly run through those 170 plus use cases as well. E-sign is legally valid under Information Technology Act. Thanks to Mr. Vakul Sharma, he already covered this aspect in his presentation. This electronic signature service, that's e-sign, can facilitate any person to digitally sign from anywhere and anytime. So this is very simple. You need not be physically present. It is presence-less as well as paperless. So you can perform e-sign. Used across the industry by government applications, banking systems, office automation platforms, ERP systems, and many more. So the use case is enormous. Anywhere you see there is a paper involved, other than what Mr. Vakul Sharma mentioned about the first schedule of IT Act, other than those five cases, anywhere else paper is involved, their e-sign can be adopted. So features of e-sign, it is globally competitive, cloud-based electronic signatures with multi-factor authentication. So very competitive. A lot of countries are looking to India as an example because the scale is massive. So people, the adoption is very massive. So globally, many countries are referring to this particular system. Remote verification using advanced face recognition technology, which I already mentioned during paperless DSC as well. It is legally valid under the SWANSO section of IT Act. It is compatible for any electronic document signing, including PDF, Word, Excel, XML, and so on. Multiple modes of customer identification, including bank KYC, other offline KYC, and organization KYC. So all those modes are permitted. Presence-less and paperless e-sign account creation. So there is no need to be present in person in CA office, or there is no need to provide the paper. Enter enrollment for e-sign is online. Just like what I told about paperless DSC, for e-sign, anyone can come to e-sign.emudra.com. They can submit an online request and your account will be processed within 30 minutes. So you get the enrollment over there after you complete that KYC process, and this enrollment is valid for 2 years. So 2 year valid e-sign account will be available with you, which you can use with the applications which are enabled with e-sign. And for this 2 year validity, you will have the credentials for using e-sign. That is basically the signer ID, that is nothing but a username, and a PIN number which you have to remember. And third thing is a mobile OTP, which has to be used for authentication. I will also run through a very quick demo on that, not taking much time. What are the benefits of e-sign? Yes, e-sign is very significant in terms of how it will be beneficial to people. First is it saves a lot of costs. I'll come to that cost section in a separate slide. Increase the productivity. So you need not wait for papers to get moved, because physical logistics, that too in this pandemic situation, is very tough. So having e-sign, you can just quickly electronically move the documents, that too with legally valid signatures. Document security, as in previous session, Dr. Balaji has already explained, it is very secure. Document is locked with the hash of that, which is signed by the private key, encrypted by private key, and verifiable at any point of time. Seamless integration. So every day we are having at least one application discussing with us to go live on e-sign. So there are a lot of applications which are integrating from different industries. It may be banking or financial or manufacturing. So several industries are in discussion. So it is very seamless to integrate with the existing system. Instant signing from anytime, anywhere. E-sign helps you sign from anywhere. So even you need not be in India, because nowadays international roamings are enabled, provided the situation allows you to travel. And if you have an e-sign account, you can go to any country and just receive the OTP, or you can enable TOTP. So you need not even wait for SMS, and you can authenticate for e-sign. I'll show that particular flow. There is no dependency on hardware crypto tokens. This is a usual challenge what we face when we ask people to digitally sign. They say they do not have the USB crypto token. So in eSign, it is fully cloud enabled. So we manage the keys online as per the IT Act regulations. So there is no need that you should have the hardware crypto token. So there is no dependency of hardware tokens. Simplified user experience, yes, because whenever you would have used the USB tokens, you have to install the USB token driver, then some tool to have it access, make some settings in Internet Explorer. So a lot of challenges. eSign doesn't have those complications. It is much simple as you do anything on your mobile on or even on the web browser. So it can be just done on those applications. And as I said, compatible with all devices, mobile, desktop, tab, or whatever devices. Even there are some use cases where some kiosks are being done at banks, where in the kiosk, they can digitally sign any customer onboarding document. Cost comparison of eSign, because this is always a question for adoption, but yes, there are so many conversations happening. So I'm just comparing available major three options. One is DSC, so digital signature certificate. Typically the prices, end user prices are 1,000 plus. I'm including the token cost as well. So token plus digital signature certificate will cost about 1,000 rupees per year. There is lack of user experience if you see in DSC, because as I said, you have to connect the token, get the system configuration and use it. Then logistics to apply and get the DSC is not so easy. So that's a challenge. Then hardware token dependency is always there. So this is the DSC. eSign version 2 is something what was before the Supreme Court order, and post Supreme Court order also it has been used for government use cases, the direct benefit transfer, as well as the PMLA related use cases, that is in the banking. These have been used. So that is eSign version 2. But here the major issue came was the cost, because UIDAI imposed for non-government a cost of 20 rupees per transaction and plus eSign transaction cost of 5 rupees. So effectively per every transaction, there is a cost of about 25 rupees plus GST. Then there is a moderate success rate, because what has happened eventually, several other holders have changed their mobile. So the OTP delivery is a problem. So the success rate in eSign V2 has significantly dropped. Then there is a single KYC option, which is dependent on UIDAI. So many times now the system is very much stable. UIDAI has a very robust system. But yes, if there is any law or anything which denies access to the UIDAI connectivity, then this whole eSign system will have a SLA issue. Then multi-party dependency for service provision. That is mainly there will be a KSA. There are several KSAs who are telecom providers. Then we have to connect to UIDAI. So there are multi-party dependency in the system. eSign V3, when government introduced, very thankful for this proactive movement, what government has done. The regulator was very quick in adopting this robust system. So eSign V3 has a very high success rate because there are no OTP issues. Enter KYC is with the certifying authority control. So they are able to do it very quickly and onboard for eSign. Multiple KYC options were introduced, as I explained in previous slides. There is an offline Aadhaar KYC, there is PAN KYC, different forms of KYC to onboard a user, and fully supported by single party, that is eMudhra. Like say today, if someone takes eSign V3 service from us, we can give complete SLA to them because there is no third party dependency. So everything, the service levels are managed by eMudhra. So there is complete guarantee on this. And mainly on the cost, if you see this cost comparison, we are charging, once again, there is no UIDAI overhead cost of 20 rupees. So it is just rupees 5 per transaction. Or we have also the plan of rupees 500 per year with unlimited signing. So which is very competitive compared to what is the per year cost you may incur with DSC. So this is the cost comparison. If you have any questions, we can come to that at the end. Before I move into use cases, I will have a very short demo. Just give me a moment. I'm just switching the screen. Yeah. New share. I'm just going to my browser. So this is the website for eSign, what we have. So I already have an enrolled account. So I will not walk you through the enrollment process. But as I said, if you go to enroll as individual, there is using Aadhaar or using PAN. If using Aadhaar, use your Aadhaar XML file, share code and get onboarded. That's very simple. If using PAN, there are different set of information, document attachments required, and you can do that. I will directly go to login because I have an approved account. So I'm just logging in. So I have a username, which is a signer ID. I have a PIN. I think this is right. In the OTP, there are two options. So you need not worry about the SMS OTP delivery. If you are outside the country also, you enable the TOTP once in the system, then have any TOTP authenticator app, like there is Google Authenticator, there is Authy. So there are different authenticator apps. You can use that. So I just opened my authenticator app in my system. Just 1 minute. I'm just continuing with login. I'm inside my account. So basically, if you see, this is my eSign account. It's a complete cloud account. There are recent transactions shown here. If there are any pending eSign which is initiated by any of the application service provider that will list here, you can even complete those signatures from here. For this demo purpose, I'm just going through a simple flow of upload and sign. I have already subscribed with a 500 rupees per year plan, so it is not asking for subscription again. So I am at upload and sign. I'll just choose a document. I have a trust document, I believe. I'll just say proceed for sign. Yeah. Okay. This is the document, and here if you can see this orange box, this is the signature placeholder, which in the previous session, it was shown in Adobe Reader. You saw that there was an area where you have to select for signature. In the similar manner, there is a predefined control. You can place it somewhere. Then this is more of a practice. You give the place where I am, a reason. I will just say some reason why I'm signing. And I will just say perform sign. So for every signature, there is a need to authenticate. So basically, the system should ask for an authentication now. I will just wait for this to ask for the next step. So it says my signer ID, I have to authenticate again. Because the earlier authentication for login, but for every signature, we have to authenticate and sign. So I'm just authenticating again. I'm looking for my TOTP. It also gives a facility, do not store the documents online. So we don't store the document. Then I just agree to this perform sign. There are some mandatory options. I gave a OTP in SMS OTP section. So I'm performing eSign. So it takes a few seconds to process the signature, and then yes, the signature is done. Typically it takes about 3 seconds to perform the signature. Then you can just download. So now if I open that document, I have to switch the document, just one moment. I'll just go to my PDF. Sorry about the screen, just 1 minute. So if you can see here, this is the signature already applied to this document. That was a test document which was not having any signature. Now I have e-signed. So it's at 1:55 p.m. There is a e-signature by Vijay Kumar, reason webinar location Bengaluru. So this is there. There's a green take. So everything is fine. So you can go to signature property. This is the same thing what earlier speaker has already shown on this. So same information, show signer certificate. So there is a trust chain over here and it's already trusted. So this is a very simple flow eSign. I will switch back to my presentation, what I had. This is a very small demo what I wanted to give during this webinar so that we can see what exactly is the user experience in eSign. So I'll just continue. So the last three slides, what I wanted to cover on this was the use cases. So I will not run through every use case, but there are about 17 segments what I was able to put in this slide. These are from the conversation what we are having day to day with the clients for what eSign adoption is being looked into, where they are integrating. So those kind of use cases. So if you see, there are varied use cases, and everywhere this can be implemented. I have not covered government in detail, but all other cases I have got very detailed information. So financial services, if you see banking or any kind of financial, so there are different kind of use cases, account opening, ENACH, vendor workflow, so a lot of things, insurance domain, manufacturing, information technology domain, predominantly employee onboarding kind of cases, because in IT companies, people keep coming, keep going. So all that exit and employee onboarding workflows can be easily done through e-signatures. Pharma industry has a very beautiful use case, healthcare, then education, government. SMEs also have a lot of use cases where they're using e-sign, construction, real estate, supply chain and logistics. So the different kind of use cases they use this. So a lot of papers are getting eliminated and digital signatures are being used to have those document with electronic signatures. Yeah, so the other last slide is on this other use cases. If you see any enterprise, they have sales department, human resource department, finance department, legal department. So we get a lot of inquiry on this, saying these departments want to automate these flow, and many have already successfully implemented as well, either through integrating through their ERP systems or existing application, or many of them use our own workflow platform, that is emSigner, and automate all these workflows. You see procurement, every purchase order to the vendor can be released from this, which is signed. Vendor can also accept and issue the invoice with electronic signature. So it is completely compliant with GST laws. They can e-sign the invoice and share with us, share with the supplier. And so all these use cases are taken care of. MSAs, because as Mr. Vakul Sharma already mentioned, it is only not applicable on contracts which has an interest on immovable property, but several of the contracts what enterprises have has nothing to do directly with immovable property. So we see the use cases where a lot of vendor contracts or MSAs are being signed using e-sign. There are other cases also what we saw, which we couldn't categorize it to particular industry, we have put it in a separate group. So broadly, if you see, eSign has a very larger adoption use case, which is, it is a trusted certificate. It can fit into any kind of workflow. It will be very secure. And more importantly, it can be used on web as well as mobile. So there is nothing that if you procure a DSE, you have to wait for the token to deliver, download everything here, nothing that you have to wait for these. You can just have it subscribed for like say 100 officers or 10 employees or general public, and then they can just go online with just a simple KYC procedure, which is fully online. So this is what I wanted to cover. So eMudra, we are a technology and trust service provider that offers integrated trust services and solutions. And our primary vision is enabling digital transformation. So this is what we are. So this is the presentation I had. Any questions? We can take it up now.
Thank you, Vijay.
Thank you. So let me Dr. Balaji, any questions for that?
Yeah, I'm just searching. Yes. Okay. As of now, I think there is only one question. They were seeing how the verification can be done for the e-sign that you demo that you showed. That's a question.
Okay. Verification is, as I said, is fully online. So typically, if it's an offline Aadhaar-based verification, what we do is you download the offline Aadhaar file and upload it during the enrollment flow. And then there is a mobile and email verification, which is predominantly through OTP. So you get the OTPs and you verify. After that, you will be asked to record a video. So it is a 20-second to 30-second video, which you can record and answer some of the questions asked, like say, what is your name, your date of birth, etc. And then we take up all the backend verification. There is a central processing team sitting in our offices, and they verify this record on a queue basis and then approve the enrollment. That's the verification process. And if it's a PAN KYC based enrollment, you should also have, you should also show your original documents because you are uploading scan documents during the process. So in the video verification stage, you have to also show the original documents in the video.
No, he is asking about, suppose he has received a e-signed file, So as a receiver, how he can verify? That's what he is questioning actually.
Oh, signature verification?
Ah, digital signature verification at the after e-signed file at the receiver's end.
No, receiver's end is absolutely same as what you had shown, Dr. Balaji. It's the same thing. So PDF, if you see, it is almost same thing. Only this color and image is different. But if you see on the PDF, it comes like a normal signature when you sign over the token. It is just exactly the same. You click that, you get the signature properties, etc. Yeah.
I hope.